two questions to them. Number one, you said that there is no God. So answer to this, Allah said in Surah Al-Baqarah that their own existence, your own existence is the proof that there is God. You see, I want to ask them, debate these. I'm ready to debate these atheists, giants, these all people. Your own proof is that there is God. You, yourself, where were you before your birth? If you can provide me the origins of your birth or origin of your making, then I will start listening to you. First, find the origins of your making. Then talk that there is no God. Don't waste people's time. And second thing, provide the answer that what was before the Big Bang. Do you have a knowledge before the Big Bang? You do not have it. All the knowledge which you have is a speculative knowledge. After the Big Bang, might this happen, ought to be, supposed to be, in as much so. That is the knowledge you have. We call it a weak knowledge, fragile knowledge. So knowledge of ascertain, number one is that your own existence. Allah says in Surah Fusilat, last verse, Allah says that we will show our signs to you in front of you on the horizon and within your own selves. This is inside your body, everything, anatomy, physiology. And then your heart will say that Quran is al-haq. This testimony or testification will come out from your heart, the moral within, the values within, the acceptance within, not from outside. You will say from your own heart that my own physiology, my own anatomy, the complex system and mechanism running inside my own body, leave the external sources, just see your own body. It's enough that it will bring you towards Allah. Allah says in the Quran, test yourself, forget about the things you can't even comprehend. How many living organisms have you discovered? I'm talking to the people of science, underwater. Tell me, nothing. Mariana Trench is the deepest trench. Have you ever discovered only that part? Leave the other part. Go and make a dive inside and see what things are going to come out. Only take Mariana Trench. Leave the other ocean. Oceans. So let us reason. You see how tiny, insignificant are you? And then you talk about big, you know, claims, verdicts. This is not that. This is not that. So question number one. Your own existence, where did you come from? Find the origins. If you don't have sources, don't speak against Quran and Allah. Second thing, what was before the Big Bang? Provide us the answer. And before Big Bang, Allah says it was ilmul arwa, khalqul takween. Allah says kun fayakun. When he decrees a matter, he merely says be and it is. And this is all kun fayakun is khalq at-takween. It does not require time and space, because time and space created after the Big Bang. So everything after the Big Bang is running under the order of khalq at-tadbir, functions, mechanism of physical laws of nature. If woman is pregnant, she has to bear 3 trimesters. Gestation periods of 9 months to produce a healthy baby, otherwise will appear premature birth. It could be uncanny, uncouth, or deformed baby or child. But nature says you have to wait for 9 months to make the complete cells and everything, DNA structure whatsoever. So this is the sunnah of physical. If you want to do something, you have to walk on this gravity. If you go to another places, another gravity affects. And even the theory of relativity proved. Einstein was the first one who said that all the planets are floating, swimming, not just revolving. Quran says, yasbahoon. It means something is floating and everything is floating. Push. This dark matter pushing something, heavenly bodies, and they are floating. And even rotating is on its own axis. This is another way. If you put a ball on a lake or a river, you see the ball also rotates and also floats. So this is what science and Quran says already. Stand to reason. So this is it. Before, what was it? Ilmul arwa, where there is no time required. This knowledge you can never be able to comprehend till your death. So after Big Bang, khalq at-tadbir. And if Allah wants, He can bypass this خلق التدبير into the laws of خلق التكوين. Moses, peace be upon him, when he reached to the Red Sea was split asunder with the staff of Moses, which is against the law of nature. It was خلق التكوين which Allah entered, and the property of the nature of river or gravity, it was just bypassed. Same thing happened Ibrahim, when Prophet Ibrahim was put into fire by Nimrud. He ought to burn, but the property of fire is to burn, not to make it something cool or cold. But it happened opposite. Allah ordered, it changed into khalq-e takween, and the thing was kun fayakun, the property of fire was changed. But the law of nature says it is fire and it will burn. So these all things can be changed things. Now, challenge to atheists. Provide us your own origins. And second thing, provide us what was before the Big Bang. If you cannot provide these two answers, then accept Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah says in the Quran that it does not hurt you anything if you just say and believe that there is Allah. What it gonna cost you? They're gonna give you, have to give money? No, nothing gonna cost you. Then why are you rigid? Why are you rigid? This is the message to the atheists and rest of the Muslim brethren and sisters who go to universities, and might they get in the trap of this contraption of atheism, agnosticism, skepticism. I'm standby. Everything is given to you guys. You can contact me, inshallah. And that's all for today. وَآخِرُ الدَّعْوَانَ عَنِ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ